Savannah's dress is finished. And with just a few days to go until the sweet 16th, Sondra's brought it to Chicago herself to make sure it fits. It's her first dress for a pastor's daughter, and she hopes Savannah's ideas will get her father's blessing.
We are on the edge with this one, with something that is really big, really flamboyant.
Oh my God, this is my dress.
That's your dress.
Oh my God.
Okay, let's go. Come on, you can't wait. I know you can't wait.
Oh my God.
You said big.
Oh my goodness. Oh my God.
And then this is all Swarovski crystals.
I want to already try it on already.
It's time for Pastor Anthony's verdict on the dress.
That's something you see out of a magazine 100%.
It looks like a work of art.
It's just... it's way too short. It's way too wild. Definitely gonna make a statement.
That's a lot of work.
I know. It was.
I've never had a problem.
You never dealt with real gypsies. You dealt with the Roma child? Like, they don't even know the language.
I've been making these dresses for 33 years, and just because Pastor Anthony doesn't like it, doesn't mean I don't know what I'm doing.
I don't wanna make a statement, especially because I'm a leader in the gypsy communities, and it's kind of wild, so I don't wanna get that out there. Don't get me wrong, her work was awesome. It's just not matching our culture. Roma chow, they'll wear that no problem. They're more like Americanized, but that's so not the way we dress.
What do I do?
I'm
gonna buy another one. That's what's gonna happen.
Now, let me tell you what would be awesome. She'll wear it for a little bit, obviously, and then she'll probably
change into her. Well, you guys have a custom of change dresses
anyway.
Yeah,
that's normal.
Made a compromise. This will be my grand entrance dress.
It's usually custom for the girl to change a couple times. Usually it would have been later, but it's probably gonna be more earlier because I don't want to send out the vibe that I'm endorsing wild dress and short apparel.
Pastor Anthony's preparations for his daughter's huge coming-of-age party have been a year in the making.
And a sweet 16, this is usually the time people start asking for your gypsy daughter's hand in marriage.
He's relying on the party to persuade Savannah to leave her mother's house in Hawaii for good.
Very nice. Okay.
No, I'll go get...
Kelly, Savannah, lift up the end of her dress so it won't hit the ground. It's so important for me for Savannah to marry a Christian gypsy boy.
You look beautiful, Savannah.
The sweet 16th is about to start, and the stage is set for the extravagant Paris-themed party.
My party, you know, was all decorated Paris. I was so much Eiffel Towers all around. I don't know one person who had, you know, an Eiffel Tower ice sculpture.
Hundreds of Roma gypsy families have come to honor the pastor's daughter. But the big question is, will Savannah's daring Paris dress impress the guests?
It was like literally like 100 cameras, flashes all over, like in my face. And so I felt like a movie star. I felt like all eyes were on me. I had so much attention.
When she made her entrance, it was like, wow, it was amazing. She looked like a life-size Barbie. It's beautiful.
I mean, you gotta understand, the dress was thousands and thousands of dollars. We couldn't believe the response. I was thinking, you know what, this dress is actually pretty nice. This is a beautiful dress. I don't know why we was freaking out so bad.
Savannah's dress is beautiful, really fit the theme.
And the way he's presenting his daughter with the dresses and everything else is very, very nice and elegant.
But the one person Savannah wants to show her dress to is not there.
All this time I've been planning the party, I was thinking, is my mom gonna be there? Is she gonna see me in the dress? I looked at all the crowd, and then I got a little bit more disappointed because I couldn't see my mom at all.
Pastor Anthony has gone against gypsy tradition and invited Savannah's mother, Sherry. Her husband has agreed to let her go to the party if she can find a chaperone. But unfortunately, Sherry's about to miss the next part of the celebrations.
You know, I said, who's ready for Nicholas Marks? Come on!
Savannah is following Gypsy tradition by changing outfits multiple times. She's now wearing a traditional Gypsy gown to dance in.
The dancing in the middle of all the crowd is actually a Gypsy custom to bring the girl out and let her entertain and host.
She's not allowed to dance with her own age group, only with those considered to be elders in the community.
It has to be close family and really close friends that we know for a really long time. That's the only way.
With the traditional dancing almost over, there's still no sign of Savannah's mom.
I was looking around and I couldn't see my mom at all. Everything I've been planning, I was like in the back of my mind, I was thinking, is my mom gonna be able to see this?
Then, unexpectedly, at the 11th hour, Sherry arrives.
I'm here to the party. I actually made it. I'm so excited.
Sherry has managed to find a chaperone.
My dad came with me, so I'm not shaming my husband.
The Roma Gypsy rulebook states that a divorced couple can't be seen standing too near each other.
Gypsy culture, you're not supposed to be around your ex-wife.
So Gina comes to the rescue.
It's not good to be around your ex-wife because it don't look right. People think it's disrespectful. So he did the right thing and he moved away from Sherry.
What was going through my mind was basically, okay, I gotta just keep my distance. And I was a little nervous because I don't want to be around her.
Us Gypsy people, the exes don't mingle in one room, so this is actually a miracle. You know, sincerely, it never happened like this before in Gypsy history. It's happening now. Times, they are changing.
Roma tradition continues during the meal. The men are expected to show respect to the host and Savannah by contributing to her future dowry.
This was a birthday gift, and they went around naming the person, thanking him because he came, saying how much he gave in the basket.
50. Sherry can't wait any longer. She has to know if her daughter will be coming back to Hawaii with her.
It's a hard decision to choose from being with my mom and being with my dad.
I'm proud of you, did your woman's dance.
I don't want to break anyone's heart.
What did you decide?
I'm going to stay. Is that all right?
Technically, no, but all I can do is say, you know, I'm happy for you no matter what. You know I wanted you to come with me more than anything.
In Hawaii, none of my friends are there. I'm a teenager and I want to, you know, be with my friends and have fun before I get married.
It hurts, but I'm willing to, whatever. You're my baby, whatever makes you happy. Just don't forget me, Savannah. Daughter is my life, she's my heart, and me leaving her behind, it actually feels like when she was a baby and I went off and got married and had to leave her back here with her dad. It actually feels like the same thing. I'm living my nightmare at the same time of enjoying the best thing I've ever seen in my life.
Thank God she made the right decision, a great decision. I'm happy with it, and now we could live our normal life again.
My daughter, Savannah, 16-year-old.
Savannah, God bless you.
God bless you for coming. Appreciate it.
Now that Savannah's staying, Pastor Anthony's starting the next part of his plan, introducing her to the most eligible Gypsy families in Chicago.
It would totally not be a surprise if the Gypsy families that were at Savannah's party would call me and ask for Savannah in her hand in marriage.